It's 11 p.m. and you've only just realized that the health side video you've been putting off is due tomorrow. It's time to buckle down, open up your computer, and check your phone, maybe watch some YouTube, or even play some video games. As a matter of fact, you should also check out who posted on Instagram. Actually, it's getting quite late, so you should probably go to sleep and try again in the morning. This is the cycle of procrastination. And whether or not you'd like to admit it, we've all been there.
Now, how do we stop procrastinating? Before we start, we are not medical professionals. Please seek further advice from registered medical clinicians. As a general theme, time management is helpful for working more efficiently and reducing stress. These are some ways to assist you in reducing procrastination by working more efficiently and effectively. Keep a list of all tasks that need to be completed within your daily schedule. Ensuring you won't miss anything important serves as a reminder to stay ahead and helps you regain focus faster throughout your day. Try to manage and minimize distractions as they set you back and tend to only increase anxiety associated with procrastination. To do so, you can use apps to block frequently visited networks such as Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Reddit. You can block out your time to meet the needs of your schedule and allocate a designated period for your task to be completed, helping you effectively time manage and budget your hours to get more done. Rank your tasks in order of importance to prioritize attention on work which needs to be completed sooner than others. This ensures you meet deadlines effectively and reduces distractions by unimportant work. You can use the Pomodoro technique, which helps you identify tasks and complete them within 25-minute blocks and 5-minute breaks, allowing you to reduce distractions and pushes you to become more productive in a shorter amount of time.
Ironically, procrastination is the result of our bodies trying to protect us. Specifically, by avoiding a task we see as threatening. When you realize you had to do the health side video, your brain responds like it would to any incoming threat. Your amygdala, which regulates your emotions and warns of potential threats, releases hormones that stimulate your fight, flight, or freeze response. This stress-induced response can overpower your prefrontal cortex, which regulates your rational thoughts. Researchers call this amygdala hijack. All of this can lead us to think that putting aside the video in favor of some less stressful task is a pretty good idea. This response might seem extreme. After all, it is just a deadline and not a bear attack. But we're most likely to procrastinate tasks that evoke negative feelings, such as fear, incompetence, and insecurity.
So, what is procrastination? Procrastination is often defined as trouble persuading yourself to do the things you should do or would like to do. Having roots in the Latin word procrastinus, meaning belonging to tomorrow, procrastination often involves putting off important, meaningful tasks to perform trivial ones instead. So, why do we procrastinate? People procrastinate for a variety of reasons. Most people believe that it stems from a lack of willpower, but it's mainly our intrinsic motivation that helps us overcome the habit of putting things off. Additionally, decision paralysis, which refers to how, in today's world, being overloaded with the number of possibilities and opportunities can be highly demotivating. With more freedom to make decisions and perform actions, we can become easily confused about what is important and what is not, as well as what is wrong and what is right, leading us to become less likely to do anything at all. We also tend to ignore the value of time. Time is both limited and finite. It is quite necessary to understand that every single second you waste is gone forever. Coming to this realization often helps people start managing their time more carefully. Sometimes all our opportunities seem to be at our fingertips, but we just can't seem to reach them. When you procrastinate, you waste time that you could be investing in something meaningful. If you can overcome this fierce enemy, you will be able to accomplish more, and in doing so, better utilize the potential that life has to offer. We now know that today's world is conducive to procrastinating, and learning how to overcome it is, therefore, one of the most important skills you can learn.
Thank you for watching our video. We hope you enjoyed.